Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today I'll show you how to install Tailwind CSS together with ShadCM UI, which is one of the most popular component library in React right now. By the end of this video, you will have Tailwind fully working plus ShadCM components ready to use in your project. Let's get started. So now before we get started with installing Tailwind CSS and setting it up in our project, we'll have to make sure that React has already been installed and set up completely. But we've done that already, and if you've not, you can check out our last video to see how you can do that as well. Then we'll have to continue with Tailwind CSS. So let's get started with installing and setting up our Tailwind CSS project. So I'll head to my Visual Studio Code, which is my code editor. Here you can see this is my React project. I've installed it and I've set it up. Then from there, I'll head to the Tailwind documentation website, which is this. So I will start from here. I will copy this, come to my code editor. Then I'll paste it here and run this command. This is installing Tailwind CSS along with the node module. Then you have to make sure that your internet connection is very, very fast. If not, this will take a lot of time. As you can see, mine is actually going pretty fast. And before you know it, it will be done. So once it's done, it's almost done. Yeah, it's done. Once it's done, you'll notice that your node module is here already. And it's already created a vitconfig file for you. So next is for you to head back in the vitconfig file. You have to copy this and paste. So I'll check out my vitconfig file. You can see it already has a dummy value copied. So I'll just check out the ones that have not been copied yet instead of pasting everything there so it doesn't disrupt my project. So I'll have to copy the imports, the Tailwind CSS import file. I'll paste it here. Then I'll copy the Tailwind CSS plugin as well. I'll paste it here. So that is that. Then lastly, I'll copy this, the import file. I'll paste it in my CSS file, which is the index.css. Once I'll paste it here. So that's that. We're actually done with setting up Tailwind CSS. So we'll just go ahead to test it out whether it's worked. So I'll come here. I'll just delete all these dummy values. I'll delete all of them since we are not making use of them. Just go ahead and delete them. So then I will come here, maybe in H1, then welcome to Tailwind CSS. Then I'll try on styling it, class name. I'll give it a text. Sorry, text. You can see it's working already. So I'll just do this, then run it. Just have to test it out. Voila, this is it. You can see it's styled already. Maybe to make sure that everything is, or to be certain, maybe I'll give it a class name, another class name. Maybe a background. Yeah, we are just testing it out. It's not that we are actually building anything. So I'll head back to my project. You can see I gave it a border and a background. So we are actually done with setting up Tailwind. So let's go over to setting up ChatCM into our project as well. So the next thing for us to do is to install ChatCM into our project, just like we installed Tailwind CSS. So to do that, we'll head over to the ChatCM documentation, which is this. I'll be dropping the link in the comments in the description section below. So this is the ChatCM documentation page. So they said pick your framework. So we are not using Next.js, we are not using Laravel, we are using Vite. So select Vite, it opens up. So this is it. So we are not interested in this because we've run it already, we've done this, we've imported Tailwind. So what we are interested in this is this to update our config, Tailwind config JSON file and our vitconfig.ts file. So once we update it, so all we are just doing is to copy this compiler, then head to our project here. So I've already created this, then we'll paste that compiler we just copied here. paste it here, just like this. This is how it should look like. Then we'll head back to app. Then we'll copy this, which is from the vitsconfig.cs. We'll copy this. We'll copy the parts. And this, once we copy it, we'll head back to the vitsconfig.cs. We'll paste it. This is the parts we've done that already. Then this as well, we've done that already. Then we'll copy this. This is the plugin. And once we copy this, let me just do it manually so you could see it as well. Then we can still paste it here as well. So we've actually done that. Then once we are done, we'll head back and we can fully install Shards here. So copy, we'll come, CD, navigate to my project. Then paste the command to install Shards here. So then we'll select neutral. I say, which color would you like to use as the base color? So we'll select neutral. As you can see, everything is changing. It's installing, the dependencies are installing, everything is installing. So just have to make sure that your internet connection is strong. Now we've installed everything, so we'll have to head back. Then lastly is to start installing the components. So I have copied this. I want to install the button component. So then I'll head back to my project, click it. Just notice, once this starts installing, it creates a new folder here called components. Yeah, you can see that it's created a new folder called components. So this is the button component. So I'll just head back to my project and apply this button component. So this is how you could apply it. Then I'll just have to copy this. Maybe paste it here. Then I'll also copy the import option. Paste it here. So I'll close my server and rerun it again. So we could see the changes. So once we head back to the server, can see the button function is now showing properly. So that is that. That is that. So we've successfully installed Torrent CSS and also we've successfully installed Shards here. Thank you for watching this video and look out for my next video.